Is there any difference between meditation teachings of Swami Vivekanand and Lord Buddha? Swami Vivekanand and Swami Dayananda. Now there was a talk about Swami Vivekanand. These were the two persons who influenced me so much in my life, and still I am so grateful to both of them. I had been working with Ramakrishna Mission Society in Burma. I was a managing committee member and a important person taking most of the responsibilities, both in the hospital as well as the cultural center. So much inspiring, wonderful. Every word that's said by Vivekananda inspires anybody. It's so good. Dayananda, so good. But the teaching of Buddha, the real teaching of Buddha, was lost at that time. It has come only now, because one country, neighboring country, maintained it. Otherwise it would have been lost everywhere around the world. I am so sure that such a wise person like Vivekananda or Dayananda, if they had gone through Vipassana, if they had gone through the words of Buddha, they would have been so very much attracted and they would have accepted it without any objection. Because the technique was not there. All the misunderstanding about Buddha, dukhavada, Buddha is dukhavada, he teaches only misery. What a wrong impression was there. He teaches people to come out of misery. He is sukhavada. How can he be dukhavada? But a great publicity was made for 1,500 years. Dukhavadi. So naturally, because the teaching was lost, the words of Buddha were lost, and the technique was lost. So we can't blame them. They are so wise people, both of them, Dayananda and Vivekananda, are heroes of our country. And if you go through their words, you'll get so much inspiration. Just add Vipassana to that.